हेलो एवरीवन। तो म्यूचुअल एक्सक्लूजन द बेसिक प्राइमरी रिक्वायरमेंट इज नॉट फुलफिल बाय द काउंटिंग सेमाफोर। सो टू अवॉइड टू फुलफिल दिस पर्टिकुलर रिक्वायरमेंट और म्यूचुअल एक्सक्लूजन रिक्वायरमेंट वी आर कम अप विद अ बाइनरी सेमाफोर। बाइनरी सेमाफोर इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड म्यूटेक्स। ओके, इन बाइनरी सेमाफोर इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज टू प्रोसेस सॉल्यूशन। सो बाइनरी सेमाफोर इज अ टू प्रोसेस सॉल्यूशन in which we are using two values of the semaphore variable s. One is 0 and the other is 1. If s is equal to 0, it means critical section is occupied. Critical section is occupied. And if s is equal to 1, then it means critical section is vacant. Okay, so definitely if only one process can get a chance to enter the critical section, then it means it will provide mutual exclusion, it will provide progress, it will provide bounded waiting. And what about the architectural neutrality? So we already see that semaphore is a concept which will be taken care by the operating system. So definitely it is platform dependent. That means architectural neutrality is not provided. Okay, but the main concern our is primary requirement. Primary requirement is mutual exclusion and progress, which are provided by this binary semaphore. Okay, so binary semaphore is also called mutex. And one more thing, in a counting semaphore, if let's say value of s is 3, so whenever a process, let's say process p1, process p2, process p3 and process P4 are the four processes which are trying to enter the critical section. Then process, let's say P1 get a chance to enter into the critical section, then whenever it will go into the critical section, it will decrement the value of S. It will decrement it by 1. Okay. And now process P2 get a chance, it will decrement it by 1. Process P3 get a chance, it will decrement it by 1. And now the value of S is 0. Now, whenever the value of S is 0, it means no other process will allow to enter into the critical section. Now, when process P4 trying to access the critical section, it will not allowable and it will be waited in a queue. And whenever out of these three processes, whoever comes out of the critical section, they have the responsibility to increment the counting semaphore. Let's say process P1 is come out of the critical section, then they will increment the counting semaphore by 1. So now the counting semaphore value will be 1 and process P4 get a chance to access this critical section. So in counting semaphore, whichever process gets a chance to enter into the critical section can decrement the counting semaphore value by 1, and whichever process who comes out of the critical section have the responsibility to increment the counting semaphore value by 1. So here decrement in counting semaphore, I am talking about counting semaphore, here decrement of counting semaphore and increment of counting semaphore is done by the processes. Okay, and in various textbooks they have used various notations for decrement and increment. They have used either P for decrement and V for increment, wait for increment and signal for increment. Similarly, they have used one more thing, down for decrement and up for increment. So okay, so these conventions or these terminologies are used for decrement and increment the counting semaphore value. Okay, and most of the times in the gate exams they also use these conventions to ask the questions based on the counting semaphore. Okay, so you have to be very careful while using these conventions and know exactly what is the meaning of this different terminology in the semaphore context. Okay, so counting semaphore is over, binary semaphore is over. Counting and binary semaphore are the two semaphores, are the solutions which are basically resolve the problem of deadlock arrived in producer and consumer problem. Okay, so that's all about the synchronization mechanism concept. Okay, because in GATE syllabus we have only semaphore concept in busy waiting without busy waiting solution. So after this synchronization mechanism concept, we will discuss the deadlock concept in the next video.